Hey, you. You with the teeth. Come here. Come over here. That's better. Now I can see you. You know me? Of course you do. That's because I'm famous. But even before I was famous, I was still somebody. And I got respect. See, you don't have to be famous to get respect. You just have to be somebody. And that means being confident in who you are, being willing to take chances and risk falling on your face. Because that's the only way you're gonna learn. And that's what I'm here for, to help you be somebody. Because if you're not somebody, then you're gonna be somebody's fool. Shyness.
Mind on the set in 5, 4, 3, 2.
This is a commercial for people who are...
What? I can't hear you.
This is a commercial for people who are really shy. Are you shy?
Would you please speak up?
Do you find yourself having a hard time speaking up in a crowd?
Oh, just forget it.
No! You forget it! I was asked to do this commercial about shyness, and I'm gonna finish it!
Well, I'm sorry, my mistake. No offense. Just go ahead and do it however you want to do it.
You don't have to be shy. Everybody deserves to be heard, so speak up for yourself. Thank you. And thank you.
Be somebody!
Roots. You can't know where you're going if you don't know where you're from.
See this tree here? It's tall, big, beautiful, and strong. But it wouldn't be here if it didn't have any roots. And you wouldn't be here either if you didn't have any roots. You see, roots nourish us and help us to become what we hope to be. Let me explain. I was born in Chicago, and these boots I wear are the same boots my father used to wear. And they remind me of home. But long before that, my folks was come from Africa. And they was from the Mandinka tribe. And they wore their hair like this. And these gold changes I wear, they symbolize the fact that my ancestors, they was brought over here as slaves. You see, we all have different roots.
Yeah, my dad was born in L.A. And my dad's dad was born here too. But his dad wasn't born here. He was born in Sacramento.
That's what I'm saying. Just like all these trees here, there are many different kinds, and they all live together in harmony. So can we.
If you're gonna make it, you gotta know who you are. Proud of your history and what you wanna be. We all make mistakes. It's up to us to get it straight. If we open our
state is the beat of. be somebody.
Frustration. Anger. You know, I found the best way of dealing with anger is to think nice thoughts. That way, you challenge all negative energies into something useful. More relish, I think, this year. Yeah, how about it, Jimmy? You see, you should use your temper and not lose it. Because if you lose it, you only make the situation worse. Take this out of Jimmy. Close your eyes. Imagine positive images so that you can make your anger work for you instead of against you. Okay, open your eyes. Anger. Use it, but don't lose it. Styling. Hey, everybody gotta wear clothes, and if you don't, you'll get arrested. But that don't mean you gotta let some fashion designer in New York or Paris tell you what to wear. Clothes express your personality, so express yourself and not someone else. Do Calvin Klein, Bill Blass, or Gloria Vanderbilt wear clothes with your name on it? No, of course not. So you table the label and wear your own name. Zena and Zena with that exciting walk to the grocery store. Here's Zena and Zena from San Bernardino. Thank you, Zena and Zena. Here's Marta, our subway sweetheart, taking the A-train to fashion in this graffiti-inspired creation with her mustard socks and her ketchup sash. She's a real hot dog. The hippest cat in town. Ain't no doubt when Jeff's around, with pants pegged tight and hair in thinness, he's the 80s nod to 50s splendor. Stay cool, Jeff. English bowler hat and Japanese kimono. Athena combines the very best of East and West with more than a dash of American style know-how. Whether she's fixing her bike or prepping for the prom, she's a living United Nation. But there's no need to vote on this outfit. Thank you, Athena. Dressed up with no place to go. No sweat, says Kelly. I'll just run around the block a few times. And she probably won't be running alone in this versatile outfit. Perfect for stopping traffic and starting. Who knows what?
the breaks have been going well for Manny. He's wearing the B-boy look. Need for breaking, and boy, do that look tough. Here's Janine, cool as a peppermint ice cream, in her pink ensemble and flossy white pumps. Steer every breeze, Janine. It's getting hot in here. Hey, that was great. I like that. Don't you? Gloria Vanderbilt, Bill Blass, Calvin Klein. Eat your heart out. And remember, table to label and wear your own name.
See somebody!
Peer pressure. Everyone wants to be accepted by the group, but that doesn't mean you have to accept everything the group does.
Thank you. Be somebody.
Recouping. Oh, hi there. I'm Dr. T. Have you ever been embarrassed, ashamed, or exposed? I mean, done something so absolutely ludicrous that you wish you could have moved to a deserted island and had your head in the sand? I mean, check this out. Now, how can that little brother recoup? Let's run that again. Is that recouping or is that recouping? So the next time you find yourself in an absolute ludicrous situation,
Mr. T,
don't go hide your head in the sand.
Mr. T, you're...
Recoup instead.
Your pants.
Recouping. One out of one Dr. T's recommended.
Be somebody.
Creating is a way of making your mark. Some people paint, others make music, or write. Still others make art with their body.
Try to get to the bottom without letting go of the basketball. Put your fingers in, bring them down, sliding it underneath the basketball, to your elbow, to your shoulder, switching shoulders, down to the other elbow, and out. And bring it back. Let me see you try that.
Hey, look at that.
The next thing is called the tick. It's mechanical sharp movement. Start out with your wrist, elbow, shoulder, shoulder, elbow, wrist, again. You can either do it fast or slow, it doesn't matter. By the way, this is called passing. Okay, try to do it fast. Okay, the last one I'm gonna show you, you gotta step back a little bit.
Okay.
This is called the backsliding. You have to have your weight on one leg and bent, and the other leg is straight, sliding back to the other foot, shifting the weight and changing the knee. Switch, slide, switch, slide, switch. And when you start getting the hang of it, then you can go faster. And use the mirror, it's always good. Let me see you do it.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm a practice on that. I'll be back tomorrow.
Okay.
Now that you got popping, want a lesson breaking?
Oh, man. Why don't you show me? I'll watch.
Okay, this is some basic footwork. Go ahead. You're doing up rock. into his floor work, into baby swipes, into spin around, into one baby swipe, into his introduction. Now these are windmills, high push-up windmills, where you throw your weight and you push up. And these are speed windmills.
One day you might be as good as me.
Be more than five.
You're so fat they have to jack you up to take off your shoes.
Yeah, well, you're so skinny your eyes are in single file.
Well, you're so ugly your ears stick out to get away from your face.
Well, your mama is
so... Wait a minute. Don't bring anyone mother into this. She ain't here. If it wasn't for your mother, you wouldn't be here. So remember, when you put down one mother, you put down mothers all over the world.
Somebody. Work out. What are you doing to your bodies? Popcorn, potato chip, candy, soda pop. This ain't good. You gotta keep your bodies in shape.
I'm waiting for this new gym to open on my corner.
You don't need no fancy new gym and pay all that money. This is a gym right here. Yeah. Can I borrow this?
Yes.
Can you do this?
I can do that.
That's good.
All right.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, you're getting there, all right. That's pretty good. How about your bag of popcorn? All right. What about this?
You do this? That too.
I'm gonna have to get you in shape my way. Come on, let's go. Follow me. Your feet. 10 knee bends, 20 jumping jacks, 5 push-ups, running on the spot every day. Start stretching.
Our body rock. somebody.
If you don't know it, everybody's got a rap.
But we don't all work on it.
Rapping's gotta be a rhyme. If it's not, it ain't worth a dime.
Rapping is the way of saying knock knock.
Who's there?
Me. Open the door and listen to what I got to say.
We all know it's like a jungle, and that's the way it is. Hard times and bad times are being preached to our kids. Survival is so rough, so tough, without the dollar bill. And with all the problems of the world today, we're taxed for overkill. They say the message is we're doomed, it's just like that. But believe in me and our Mr. T, that's not where it's at. That you know, and you talk about war and poverty and the cold hot subject reality. The music sounds good, but it makes you feel sad. Worried about things you wish you had. Then you go to work at school with your head held down. Wait a minute, get your face up off the ground. You gotta realize, man, I have a lot, but you better thank God for what you got. Stop being so depressed, cheer up, don't be sad, cause they ain't dropped the bomb, so it ain't that bad.
Why don't you try to make one?
Be somebody.
Okay, class, the special word for the day is friends. The dictionary defines the word friend as a noun, a person with whom one is on terms of mutual affection and respect. Where I come from, a true friend is someone that when you get bit by a snake in the big toe, they'll be there to suck the poison out. I mean, that's a real true friend.
Oh, no, a snake just bit me in the big toe.
Sometimes a true friend is hard to find. Excuse me.
Hey,
should say you're too shy. Try. How can you let the boy know that he's your kind of guy? Try. When it's love that pulls at your heart, it's only trying to give you a start. Push in the right direction. And if he means that much to you, then there's only one thing to do.
Wasn't easy, but if I can do it, you can do it too. So don't quit. Don't look at him. I'm talking to you. That's right, you. If you want to be somebody, then it's gonna take some hard work. Mr. T's tail.
Mr. T, did you ever belong to a gang when you were growing up?
No, not me. But there was a lot of street gangs in my neighborhood. I mean, a lot of them. I didn't join because my mother didn't want me to be a part of no bad boys. So I always wanted to do what my mother told me to. That reminds me of a story about Jackie and Ricky.
Who?
Well, I started at the beginning. Well, many years ago, not that many years ago, there was this young man named Ricky, and he liked this young lady named Jackie. I guess he was about 17, 18 years old, but they live on two different parts of town. Ricky lived on the south side of town, and Jackie She lived on the north side of town. Now, on where Ricky lived at, you know, there was a street gang called the Mighty Midgets. And where Jackie lived at, there was a street gang called the Crazy Cats. And they always used to fight. You know, they wanted to be the top gang in the city. They used to fight all the time. But anyway, one night there was a big dance. And Ricky went to the dance. Then he got in a fight with one of the gang members of the Crazy Cats. And that's the part of town where Jackie lived at. And so therefore, when Jackie's mother heard about that, then she was really sure that Ricky was part of the gang. And Jackie was trying to explain to her mother that Ricky wasn't a gang member. But
what?
I can't remember. I might get the story wrong. You got to go read the ending yourself.
Read it. Didn't you make this up?
Well, half and half. I halfway made it up, and half of it was true. Well, the real story is called Romeo and Juliet, and it was written by this English guy named William Shakespeare.
That English dude? I thought he only wrote old-time stories.
No, little brother. He wrote a lot of good stuff. And you can check him out at the library. And reading can be fun. It can take you places you've never been. It can inspire you to make your dreams come true. Really?
Be somebody.
Daydreaming.
We'd like to welcome all our latecomers to the final game of this Be Somebody League season. And we remind all our friends and supporters to put their picnic straps in the garbage can. Let's leave the field as clean as we found it. Mary's at bat for the Be Somebody Giants right now, and the count is 3 balls and a strike.
All right.
Two.
That's all right. Wait for a good one. Wait for a good one. Wait for the good one.
I know I can do it. Coach T says I can too. Someday, I'm gonna play in the World Series. It'll be just like this.
The action here at National Stadium. The count's 3-2 on Mary with 2 away in the bottom of the ninth, and the bases are all loaded up. Her entire team standing out in front of the dugout. This is the pitch that's gonna make the difference. All right, here comes the windup.
There'll be millions of people watching me. And they'll be cheering for me.
Mary's the first woman to play in a World Series, and on top of that, she'll be on her way to Rookie of the Year if she can manage to wrap this one out of here. Here's the pitch.
I'll win the game, and I'll dance around the bases.
A towering swing.
Yahoo!
All right. Daydreaming. If you can see it, you can be it.
Be somebody.
Well, that's it. I want to thank you for hanging out with Mr. T. I'll see you again very soon. I'll be ready whenever you push that rewind button.